Welcome by For the Passion of the Fashion, the YouTube channel. We are tonight at Café Bel Air, Live Stage Bel Air. And there's the promoter, Johnny, with the boss of the club and her husband. And gonna see tonight two progressive power heavy metal bands. One band is from Belgium and they're called Max Pie. And the other band is Edge of Forever. And they're from Italy. And we're gonna enjoy a night of good melodic power progressive metal. Let's go inside and see what's gonna happen inside. Welcome. We are here with Astrid. She's the owner of this beautiful place, the Bel Air in Breda. Welcome, Astrid.
Thank you. You're welcome, Marco.
Are you happy that the doors go open for live music again?
Yes, tonight we have a great band from Italy, Edge of Forever. So, yeah. That's the first in a long time. And there are more to come, like Hardline. Hardline is coming.
Impact, Air Danger.
Picture.
Yeah. Oh, wow.
There are Dutch bands, so the locals please come.
Yes.
And there are more international bands to come. So if you're in Holland, come to Breda, to Bel Air. And I have our own radio show. So
yeah.
Like AOR, Rock, Hard Talk, Progressive Metal, as long as it's not dead, or Thrash Metal.
Yeah.
I'm playing it in my radio show. So
check cool.
Bel Air, the rocks.
And what I want to ask you, because most clubs are, or they are focused on like blues rock and this kind of things, or they are focused on the more extreme stuff.
Yes.
Your bar is more focused on the melodic hard rock,
yes,
right?
That's right.
And that's quite unique in the Netherlands, right? Isn't it?
I know, because a lot of venues in Holland, they have more the death metal.
Death thrash, hardcore punk, yeah.
I like melodic hard rock.
Yeah.
From Eclipse Steel, DGM, Dream Theater, Grey.
Yeah.
So I like that kind of music to.
To the Bel Air bar. It looks a very cozy bar. It looks very like a lot more like a brown cafe.
Yes.
Yeah, it's cool. And.
It is, but we have the possibility to also have a great band here.
And the last question, what are your favorite personal bands? Because you have run a AOR hard rock, progressive hard rock metal bar.
Yes.
What are your personal favorite bands?
I like the hard rock bands from the 80s, like Hardline is coming here,
yeah.
Winger,
yeah.
I was a great fan of Gotthard.
Okay, from Germany.
Steve,
yes.
But I also like more progressive metal, like DGM, Dream Theater,
oh, wow.
My favorite.
Wow, you have a nice bar in Breda. I hope to come more often if I'm welcome, of course, with my show.
Yes, of course.
And we're gonna have a nice evening, I hope. Thank you very much, Astrid.
You're welcome.
Bye. Some guys from Apeldoorn, Emil, I know for years. And these are two friends. What's your name?
Ben.
And you?
Benny.
And you traveled all the way from Apeldoorn to see Edge of Forever? You already followed this band? Because I was not so familiar with them, but I was familiar with Hardline, of course. You are really familiar with them already?
No. Not me. Those guys.
Those guys, okay. So all the way to here, and last week I saw you already at Deadlord, the Little Devil, right? You were there guys too? Are you excited we can go to stage to concert here? Yeah, okay. I see you smiling. Yeah, great. Thank you guys. Have a good night. We are here with two people from Belgium who work also for DMC. Are you guys happy to be here in Breda tonight?
Of course. It's 2 years ago. We had something.
And you are familiar with the bands tonight?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I know them.
You saw them yesterday also in Belgium?
No.
Oh, okay. Well, you're happy to be here and to...
Sure, very happy.
Yeah? So let's rock hard.
Yeah, okay.
Thank you very much.
Welcome, welcome. For the passion of the fashion. You already saw we are in Bel Air Bar, live venue in Breda. First time I'm here and it's really cool. It's not far from my home actually, Tilburg. And I'm here to have a great evening with this Italian musician, all-round musician, worked for many bands all over the world, and has his own band also, Edge of the Forever, today.
Yeah.
Welcome, Asandro.
I'm very happy to be here, and thank you for taking some time for us.
You're welcome.
It's very appreciated.
Sorry I read on paper, because I made the paper questions last minute, so people don't blame me, okay, please.
First of all,
I'm really happy to see you and to be here. How is it to be back on the road again?
Well, it feels like yesterday when we stopped touring, but it also feels kind of strange because we've been going through some countries and regulations changed over the countries. We got to Belgium yesterday, which was no mask, no nothing. We get here, nothing. Then tomorrow we're going to Switzerland, and maybe it's going to be different. And then back to Italy, and then it's going to be different as well. But it feels good. It's great. I mean, we have two records to promote, because the first one was released right before the pandemic. So I mean, we had a lot to recoup. So we're very grateful that we can be here. Very grateful that people are starting to get on the road again. Yesterday was the first show that was done in that venue in two years. So it's
where was it?
In Bielsen.
South of Johnny and the DMC Group.
South of Evan. So
great.
Yeah, and it feels good. It feels great. Honestly, it feels good to be back. Yeah.
Awesome. I'm also happy to be on the road again. And these people were filming probably also.
Yeah, totally.
You started with playing music on a very young age. I saw your day of birth, and you're younger than me. So it seems you started at a very young age, right?
Yeah, I started when I was around 12.
Okay.
Even if, at 12, I decided I wanted to be a musician. But I grew up in a very musical family, which, back in the day meant the hi-fi always running. There was always music that was going on in the house, and my father is a big fan of the Beatles, Jimi Hendrix, Jethro Tull, Uriah Heep, and lots of bands. And my favorite record when I was five was "Sending Good by the Pound" by Genesis. So,
really? Okay. You're always into progressive things. Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, when I was five, can you imagine?
Yeah,
so I was raised.
I can imagine it was the same, but not progressive.
Yeah, but so I grew up in a very musical environment, and then one day I heard Bohemian Rhapsody for the first time, and it totally changed my perception of the world.
Yeah.
Because that day my dad came home, and I told him, "Papa, I want to be like Freddie Mercury. I want to play.
Okay.
I want to sing, and I want to write songs for the people." I told him, "I want to create the same effect that I had today with Bohemian Rhapsody to other people." So,
How is the play in so many bands? Because you have many bands, but you work for so many musicians. I saw a list of Jessica Soto, Jordan Lander, Hardline.
Yeah.
Just a so big list. Ingrid Malmsteen, I saw. Jessica Soto was.
Marcel Jacob.
Anyway.
Lots of musicians from.
Lots
from,
of musicians.
From Ingrid Malmsteen, for sure.
How is it that to be in so many bands and to play for so many musicians and write songs, and how can you do that? How is your life look like?
Well, my life is very structured, but also I like the energy that comes when the deadline rings.
Yeah.
So I try to be organized, but I also let the universe do their job. And I feel I have so much music in me, and I'm very grateful that I can do it. So I never focus on the fact that I'm doing so many things and, oh my God, I don't have enough time, or what if I didn't do this, what my life would be. But this is music for me, it's my first nature, it's my first skin, and to make music for me, it's a privilege. So I take it with lots of respect and gratitude, and every day I just wake up and I feel grateful that I can make music. So for me it's awesome. A blessing.
It's
yeah.
awesome because you're a multi-instrumentalist.
Yeah.
You do a lot of instruments and
yeah.
you're an all-round musician, right?
Yeah, yeah. And to me, and I always make jokes with my fiance because she goes like, why? Yeah. And I always tell her, well, I can literally play. It's not playing an instrument. For me, it's a game.
Yeah.
Because it's every day I got new challenges that I can do. Because obviously when you're a person on demand,
yeah.
it's great, it's a great feeling, but also you have to deal with the fact that there's lots of expectations that don't bring me down. They fire up my inspiration even more. So every day for me it's a fantastic day to be more grateful and to do more things.
And you come and play tonight in Breda with Edge of Forever, a band you started back in
2004. Was our first album, but the band was formed in 2002. So
yeah,
20
years ago. Time flies.
Yes.
And what do you think about tonight? What can we expect tonight here in Bel Air Bar?
Well, it's our first time in Holland, so you know, crossing fingers. It's gonna be a great show of people, and no matter how big or small the crowd, we always deliver the goods in our way. We're very I would say driving band. Great show on stage, and no matter the situation, we always deliver. So,
you work for tons of musicians and play many bands. We already talked about it. But what are the most important ones of them, or is everything equal for you? Is everything?
So obviously, I mean, in the way I do things, all are equal.
Yeah.
I always try to give my best, and it's my priority to give my best. Everyone, but obviously, Edge of Forever and Hardline. I mean, Edge of Forever is 20 years of my life, and Hardline is more than 10 years of my life. And
yeah.
you know, obviously, these are my main bands, but also with Jorn, we do a lot. We've been working for years from the beginning, so you know, it's still part of my heart. I would say. That Edge of Forever and Hardline are my main one. Yeah.
Because the next question is also about this hard rock band from America, Hardline. It's an amazing band, and I see they're gonna play in Europe again, Belgium, Holland, Germany, and organized by DMC. They also help Europe with this tour. Yeah. What do you expect from coming over here? What are you excited to come back to?
And
the lowlands.
Yeah, I mean, and we were supposed to play with Hardline back in 2020, so right before the pandemic, everything was announced and canceled.
Yeah.
Consequently, so we're very happy to be in Holland for the first time. And we have a we have a long relationship with DMC and Gian Irina,
Italian guy,
so we're very excited to do it.
Great. I want to ask you, because Johnny is my friend, he's your friend, he's our friend, the DMC is a great organization. I want to ask you, can you make a little promotion talk for the concert you want to give for DMC and for the tours coming up?
Yeah.
A little promotion talk would be really
good. Yeah, DMC is our partner for Hardline and Edge of Forever for Benelux. And so Belgium, the Netherlands, and we're always happy to work with Johnny because he's been supporting us.
Yeah.
And I met Johnny the first time, something like 14 years ago, so we always stayed in touch, and we always have helped each other, which is what, in my opinion, makes a relationship, working relationship, something that's very strong, because it's not just one where, okay, you find the gigs for us, it's more like a family thing.
Nice. And very last question, not final question, actually, because your discography is not a half hour is not enough, actually.
Yeah.
But we need to go, we need to play, we need the show must go on. I want to ask you, do you have a final words for the message for the viewers who watch the channel?
Yeah, sure. Thank you very much for watching the interview, and if you're curious to hear what I do or what Edge of Forever does, if you go on YouTube, you can find our latest singles from our latest album called Seminole. It's out on Frontiers Music, so if you just Google or go on YouTube and look for Edge of Forever Seminole, lots of songs will come out, and enjoy.
Well, I want to thank Alessandro for his great interview. We're gonna make some little live videos tonight also. Put them all together, and you will. I hope everybody enjoyed watching. And
sure.
For Fashion of the Fashion, like, share, subscribe now. Rock on.
Ciao. Rock on. Ciao.
Here with Thibaut. He's from the progressive French Belgian metal band Max Pie. And it's the second time for you here in Bel Air, right?
First time, I think it was in 3 or 4 years ago.
Just for COVID.
Just before
COVID, yeah. And you like it here, this cafe?
Yeah, it's very cool. We play with DGM.
DGM, yeah?
Yes, I was there.
You were there? Okay, cool.
And European tour.
Yeah.
20 shows.
20 shows? Oh wow, that's a long tour.
Very nice tour.
Yeah? And you're excited to play here again? That doors go open and that people come to shows again and that you can travel around with your band and sell CDs and make shows? Yeah? Well, have fun tonight and rock the stage.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you very much, my friend. Okay, bye. Thank you. What's your name?
Ray.
Ray, and you're all the way from Germany.
Yes.
And you traveled with the band Edge of Forever all around Europe.
Yeah.
Yeah?
I pick up Italy, and yeah, then from Italy... Oh.
Wow.
You're to Belgium.
Oh, wow,
here,
cool.
And tomorrow we drive Switzerland,
oh,
Tribach.
So...
back in Italy.
Wow.
That's so, rock and roll weekend.
That's rock and roll, man. I see you have a nice Doro jacket on your...
Yeah, I drive the Doro, I drive Bonfire, I drive...
Oh, you drive Bonfire?
Grimadori.
Oh, the German driver.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you very much, Tibor. What was your name?
Ray.
Ray. Oh, Tibor was the other guy. Okay, have a guys, nice evening, Ray.
Boss.
Boss. Hello, boss. Hello, boss.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm very fine, Marco. Thank you.
Are you happy to be in Breda,
yes,
tonight?
Of course. Good music, Max Pike, Edge of Forever, Alessandro Del Vecchio. He's a genius.
Yes, and a nice guy also, eh? That's and a nice guy as well, eh?
He's a very nice guy. Very small, but very nice.
And I hear a little bit, thanks to Johnny, that we are a little bit partners now, eh? You and me, eh?
Yeah, with Glam Slam Fest and All Star Fest and everything.
Okay, because you also work with this nice guy from Belgium, with Johnny. And what's on our list for the next shows? Can you show me something?
No, not because I will show you. I have to take my phone.
You have to take your phone to show us.
Yes.
Don't show me the obscene screens, you know? Okay.
So this is
what's going up.
This is the new flyer that's coming up.
Yeah.
The Bel Air promoting.
Yes.
With Hardline Rebel Star,
yes,
April the 9th.
Oh, wow.
Crash Diet, Sjerruf Lane.
Is Crash Diet also coming here?
Yes, on okay, the 15th of May.
Okay.
Then we have Grand Slam Fest.
Yes.
In Belgium, All Star Fest. Candlemass, all doing by Gianni.
Yes.
And then we have the Cacao Fabriek in my hometown, Helmond.
Yeah.
With two L's, of course. Helmond.
Helmond.
Yes.
Okay,
and
wow.
And then Vinnie Moore is coming. It's also a
show by Oh, that's a great
a
name.
Show by
added Gianni. To that, to the schedule.
Yeah.
Great.
And I wanna say, Drum Beats,
yeah,
is a book originally by Rush drummer Neil Peart.
Oh.
Yes. And there's a Dutch guy, Ronald van...
Oh, wait. Keep it silent.
Yeah?
Yes. Yeah, Drum Beats, yeah.
There's a Dutch guy... There's a Dutch guy, Roland van Dalfse,
yeah,
who did the Dutch translation of his other book, Ghost Rider, and how he's looking for some money, a crowdfunding for that one, for the new translation for this book.
Now, and then we are happy to have you, because
yes,
probably you have enough money to pay the book, right?
Do I have enough
money? I guess you have.
I heard a guy say that we are Dutch people, that some Dutch people, no, some foreign people, I think that you and I are millionaires. So
oh, yeah, yeah, they
I
think so,
rumor,
yeah.
But
that rumor goes around. The rumor goes around.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
Okay. Now, well, we'll see. If I'm a millionaire, I can come... what do you want to drink? Hey, guys, have a nice evening. Thank you very much.
Yes.
Thank you.
Here he is, the big boy, Marco van Empel, from Headbangers Records, Headbangers Zine, Headbangers Gigs, Headbangers...
For the Passion, Not the Fashion, the YouTube channel.
Yes, of course.
And Slave for Johnny.
Slave for Johnny.
Okay, cool.
How are you doing, Marco?
I'm fine.
Yes?
I had two calm years where I can sleep on the weekends.
Yeah.
And now I need to go out again. Go to shows,
yeah.
Meet people, meet bands, listen to bands,
yeah.
Check out bands, sign bands, book bands.
Having interviews?
Having interviews, everything.
Yeah.
So I'm very happy to be here again.
Okay, in Breda, in the Bel Air.
Breda, Bel Air.
Okay.
For the passion, not the fashion.
And as forever has started, so we're gonna...
We are here with Leonardo DiCaprio from Lord Vulture and Burn. And show your shirt, Lord Vulture. Okay, cool. Are they still active, by the way?
Are they still?
Active with you
they're
again?
They're still active, not with me.
Not with you, okay.
With me.
So not necessary to watch anymore. Oh, don't say that. Okay, cool. Hey, we are here with Johnny, the big boss of DMC Agency. And very big. And we are here at Bel Air Bar in Breda. Are you happy to be here, Johnny?
First of all, I'm really happy to be here because after 3 years of the COVID shit, it's one of the first shows when I can attend with a lot of friends. Didn't expect to see him, but I hope you see him.
No, yeah. And COVID hug, little
this,
COVID
this
hug.
This beautiful guy here.
No, he we skip him.
Skip me. Thank you. Really happy to be here because we had like, a couple of years of stress.
Yeah, and, can imagine.
We don't show and so on, but we are back to normal.
A new normal.
It's the big question at the moment, but let's stay positive and say okay, let's enjoy the evening. I'm happy to be here.
Just a last really question.
Nice, really nice club, Bel Air.
Yeah. You do more shows here at Bel Air, right?
I'm working for a couple of years here, and I must say, like Astrid and Simon.
Great people,
great.
And they have a radio show also, they told me, and very passionate people.
Yes. And a great band tonight.
What we are doing like DMC is just not only working with Bel Air, but
no.
What we do is working with good partners and good bands.
Yes.
And that's our formula we try to do, is to give the fans the best possible. I'd be really happy to be partners with Bel Air.
And can you give like 3-4 recommended shows people who need to go?
It's difficult to ask because we are doing so many shows, and all the shows that we are doing is visit cast. Because every show that we are doing, from the small band to the big band, it doesn't matter which band it is, every band that we promote, we book, is worth to go to. So I can only advise, go to a website.
Yes.
Check our website, check our shows, and go to it, go for it, because they're all good.
Okay, thank you very much, Johnny, and have a good night.
Thank you, man.
Leon, and the beautiful woman here. What's your name?
Marie.
And where are you from?
France.
Francais, okay. Okay, enjoy its sight, okay?
Can pull you down. Thank you.
We've been missing your smiling faces for two fucking years! And I hope you missed our faces as well. Did you miss us? I'm not so sure. Did you miss us? Oh, I love that. Okay. We're gonna have a journey through our history between all the new albums and the old albums, but we're gonna concentrate on our new album called Seminal, which is a very great album that you should all have. Do you have our album Seminole?
Yes!
Okay, he doesn't have it, so we gotta buy one for him, but I'm sure you're gonna enjoy this one. This is called Get Up On Your Feet Again!
Yeah.
So here at Metal Daddy Ed and me on our way back to Tilburg. Hey Ed, you enjoyed the show tonight?
Yeah, it was very nice music, very good sound.
Yeah.
So, yeah, some venues can learn about it.
So, that's the specialist speaking. Thank you for watching. Like, share, subscribe now. And we're going to Tilburg. Bye bye.
Yeah, with very good music.
Yes.